culture poetry recital. Each of our students have spent time choosing these poems that I think really represent them, their characters, their personalities. I know in the owls are very creative and imaginative, and they make these beautiful stories every single day. So they have chosen great poems, I think, that represent them as students this year so far.
Yeah, we are so happy to see everyone and so excited for this event. And just want to say to all the owls and hawks and eagles, take a deep breath in. And when you get to this part right here, just take your moment, right? We all love you in this room, and we're all proud of you, and we just want to hear you and let you show us everything that you memorized and learned about poetry and public speaking and how to project your voice, right? So let's remember to take that moment. The hawks all love animals, and not really planned, but by chance, they all have poems about animals. Some of them have poems about animals that they really love. So, thank you again.
And the Eagles seem to have picked a nice variety of poems and did a lot of hard work memorizing them. And just want to acknowledge that it's a true community event and thank you to all the families supporting the students in working on their poems. And it's been really cool. It's something that we've seen them be really proud of. So thank you for that.
That's my father thumping the ground. Thunder, that's my uncle beating his chest. grows upon her back, she eats a little for a snack, and sleeps all day above the ground, upside down, just hanging around. At night, she'll climb a two-toed peak, looking for some news to eat. She hides and chews without a sound, upside down, just hanging around. Once a week, she will descend, hoping not to meet her end. She'll do her business on the ground, but not for long while hanging around. When she's done, she'll climb a tree, and she'll aim gracefully. I think you'll know where she'll be found, upside down.
Also by Janet Eslon. This cartoon bandit rubs his hand together, ready for a minute crack. Innovating joke that would be such a simple the penguin idea number so.
port is near, the bells I hear, the people all exulting. I'll follow eyes the steady keels of vessel grim and daring. But oh heart, hard heart, oh the bleeding drops of red, are on the deck my captain lies, fallen cold and dead. My captain, rise up and hear the bows. Rise up, for you the flag is flung, for you the bugle trills. For you bouquets and urban beauties, for you the shores are crowded. For you they call the swaying mass, their eager faces turned. Dear captain, dear father, this arm beneath your head. It is some dream where on the deck you've fallen cold and dead. My captain does not answer, his lips are pale and still. My father does not feel my arm, he has no pulse nor will. The ship is anchored safe and sound, its voyage closed and done. From fearful trip, the victor ship comes in with object won. Exult, O shores, and ring, O bells, but I with mournful tread. Walk the deck, my captain lies, fallen cold and dead.
Scarcely visible, the corn stood a mound.
Since then, 2 centuries, but each feels shorter than the day. At first sunrise, the horses' heads were towards eternity.
Sings at dawn and clouds and plants the land.
fosters this really beautiful environment where we get to explore our voice and have fun with lots of different songs that some are chosen. Some are traditional, like traditions from Red Fox, and then some are chosen by students that they hear on the radio and they just really want to sing them. And that's kind of also how we explore music in music class. So just making sure that everybody's having fun and they feel confident to explore and see what music means to them. So we've chosen two songs to start us off. And the first one is One Voice by the Wailing Jenny. You need something? Okay. Are you sure? Thanks. I think that's how you say their name. Then we have Katie Brill. We have, okay, wait, first.
You have worked so hard, and you just did it. It's giving me goosebumps. So nice job. I hope you're really proud of yourself for all the hard work you put into getting there. And it reminds me, I know it's another Karen quote, but it did remind me of the 32nd president of our United States, Franklin Roosevelt, who talked about happiness is the joy of achievement and the creative process. And this is the process. I was with you the day you chose your poems, and that energy and excitement and intention that you made when you chose your poems. And I remember Gabriel saying to me, "I'm going to choose three poems." Gather with your hands one more time and applaud.